Brady Bunch was an American television situation comedy that had aired in September of 1969, but was a very popular show that was watched in the 1970s. The show was created by Sherwood Schwartz, and spinoffs such as The Brady Kids and The Brady Bunch Variety Hour have been made featuring the original cast.
Keep on, keep on.
Why they didn't tell us about this?
Where did they get those costumes?
Martha Vaughn and Jager Kendall reporting live from the 70s News.
The world's first jumbo jet, the Boeing 747, has its first commercial flight on January 2nd of 1970. The plane was operated by Pan Am, and the flight traveled from New York to London carrying 332 passengers and 18 crew members. The Boeing 747 revolutionized air travel and the commercial airline business, as the jumbo jet could now carry up to 550 people during one flight.
In 1971, people had been wanting the voting age to be lowered to 18 years old ever since FDR lowered the draft age to 18 years during World War II. President Nixon signed the amendment on July 5, 1971. NASA's Apollo 14 mission to the moon was launched on January 31st. This was the third successful manned mission to the moon, and the crew consisted of Commander Alan Shepard, Stuart Roosa, and Edgar Mitchell. There were some issues with docking the modules that were overcome after several attempts. Daniel Ellsberg, a government consultant, gained access to some of the classified documents and leaked them to New York Times in June of 1971. The reports revealed many large-scale attacks that the U.S. Republic were not afraid of, causing many U.S. citizens to lose trust in the U.S. government. The general feeling was that the U.S. government had misled the public and withheld the truth.
In 1972, September 5th, 4:30 a.m., eight flight members of the Black September carrying duffel bags loaded with AKM, assault rifles, pistols, and grenades scaled a 2-meter chain-link fence into the Olympic Village. 9:30 a.m., terrorists demand the release and safe passage to Egypt of 234 Palestinians and non-Arabs jailed in Israel, along with two German radicals held by the German penitentiary system. In exchange for the hostages, 6 p.m., terrorists demanded safe flight to Cairo in Egypt and demanded negotiators pretend agreement, although Egyptian Prime Minister Azez Sedki had already told the German authorities that the Egyptians did not wish to become involved. 11 p.m., German authorities give the order for snipers positioned nearby to open fire and take out the terrorists. 12:10 a.m., three of the terrorists survive. All hostages are killed. One German police officer is also killed in the gunfight. NASA's space shuttle program was officially launched during January. President Nixon approved the program and announced its inception to the American public. The purpose of the program was to create a reusable spacecraft with the ultimate goal of reducing the cost of space exploration and making it more commonplace.
In 1973, the U.S. ended its involvement in the Vietnam War after the signing of the Paris Peace Accords during January. The agreement was signed between North Vietnam, South Vietnam, Viet Cong, and the U.S. The formal name of the agreement was an agreement ending the war and restoring peace in Vietnam, and it detailed an all-around ceasefire in Vietnam and the withdrawal of all U.S. forces and removal of U.S. bases to be completed within 60 days. It also mandated that North Vietnam release all prisoners of war, and outline the details and terms for an eventual peaceful unification of Vietnam. About 200 Ogallala, Lakota Native Americans, and members of the American Indian Movement began their occupation of Wounded Knee in South Dakota during February of 1973. AIM, a militant civil rights organization, was created in the late 1960s with the intention of bringing attention to injustices faced by Native Americans. Wounded Knee was located on the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation, and in 1890 it was the site of a massacre of 300 unarmed Sioux by the U.S. Cavalry. At the start of their occupation, AIM took 11 hostages and asked that the U.S. government start investigating broken treaties, the Bureau of Indian Affairs, and all of the South Dakota Sioux reservations. The occupation lasted 71 days, during which they negotiated with the U.S. Marshals and exchanged regular gunfire with federal agents. In May, the group surrendered and government officials agreed to start investigations as demanded.
In 1974, following the impeachment hearing started on May 9th, Richard Nixon becomes the first U.S. president forced to resign after the Watergate scandal on August 9th. The Kootenai Native American tribe in Idaho declares war on the United States. Stephen King, a 26-year-old author, published his debut novel, Carrie. During April of 1974, Carrie was actually the fourth novel that King had written, but the first to be published, helping the launch of his prolific career.
In 1976, the Apple Computer Company was established by Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak during April of 1976. Jobs and Wozniak created their company with the intention of developing small, easy-to-use computers that could be used at home or in offices, what would later become known as the personal computer. Apple computers emphasized graphics, portability, and a simple user interface. The U.S. presidential election between Democrat Jimmy Carter and the Republican incumbent General Ford takes place in November of 1976. NASA unveiled the first space shuttle, the Enterprise, to the public during September of 1976. The Enterprise was only a prototype created to conduct test flights.
In 1977, the king of rock and roll, Elvis Presley, is found dead in the apparent heart attack of the age of 42. Presley died suddenly at his mansion in Graceland, Memphis, Tennessee. The first all-in-one personal computer, the Commodore PET, was introduced as a prototype at the Consumer Electronics Show during January of 1977. PET, or PET, stood for the Personal Electronic Transactor and was the world's first PC to be sold to regular retail consumers.
In 1978, NASA unveils the first group of women astronauts during January. The group included Shannon Lucid, Margaret Ray Seddon, Catherine Sullivan, Judith Resnick, Anna Fisher, and Sally Ride. The Double Eagle balloon, piloted by Larry Newman, Ben Abruzzo, and Maxie Anderson, became the first balloon to complete a transatlantic flight during August. The helium-filled balloon traveled over 3,000 miles, carrying the three men in a trip that lasted just over 137 hours. They began their journey in Presque Isle, Maine, and landed in Missouri, France, near Paris. The gondola that carried them measured just 15 times 7 times 4.5 feet.
In 1979, the United States and the Soviet Union reached an agreement during the Strategic Arms Limitation Talks during June of 1979. U.S. President Jimmy Carter and Soviet leader Leonid Brezhnev signed the SALT, the second treaty in Vienna, after having held several talks regarding the reduction of nuclear arms. From 1972 to 1979, the Voyager 1 spacecraft was launched in September of 1977 with the mission of gathering information on Jupiter and exploring the outer edges of the solar system. On March 5th of 1979, Voyager 1 made its closest approach to Jupiter and made observation about the moon's rings, radiation, and magnetic fields of the solar system's largest planet. Voyager 1 is still exploring space as of August in 2012. Spacecraft entered interstellar space and will continue exploring indefinitely.
This is sports in the 70s. Bobby Hull, the Chicago Blackhawks All-Star, led the NHL in assists and goals in multiple seasons, earning him the nickname the Golden Jet. The Miami Dolphins. They completed an undefeated season and won the Super Bowl in 1972 against the Washington Redskins. Mark Spitz. At the time, he was the world's greatest swimmer. Mark won 7 gold medals in the 1972 Munich Olympics. Black September. The Munich Massacre was an attack during the 1972 Summer Olympics in Munich, West Germany, in which the Palestinian terrorist group Black September took 11 Israeli Olympic team members hostage and killed them along with a West German police officer. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Legendary Lakers basketball player had a record 19 All-Star Game selections and won 6 NBA championships. The Pittsburgh Steelers. The Steelers in the 70s were known as one of the greatest dynasties with the best records and 2 Super Bowls in 4 different seasons. Jack Nicklaus. Jack Nicklaus, nicknamed the Golden Bear, is an American retired professional golfer. He is widely considered to be one of the greatest golfers of all time. Over a quarter century, he won a record 18 major championships. The 1972 Olympics, with a gold medal basketball game between the U.S. and the Soviets, was one of the most controversial calls ever in basketball.
The Soviets inbound, and almost immediately, the apparent final buzzer goes off.
We celebrate. Court, people empty out, came out of the stands onto the court. The court was full of fans jumping around, flags were
waving. Can you imagine as a kid all your life thinking about?
And suddenly,
this keep out. There are another 3 seconds less.
De wedstrijd was nog niet over. Over te doen.
Well, confusion reigns. Shot by Doug Collins of Illinois State. Now the clock shows 3 seconds. There is time. Foul shot by Doug Collins of Illinois State. Now the clock shows 3 seconds. There is time.
In this clip, Hank Aaron hits his record-breaking 715th home run.
14. Here's the pitch by Downing. Swinging. There's a drive into left center field. That ball is going to be out of here. It's gone. It's 715. There's a new home run champion of all time, and it's Henry Aaron. The fireworks are going. Henry Aaron is coming around third. His teammates are at home plate, and listen to this crowd. Drive into left center field. That ball is going to be out of here.
During the 1970s, fitness became a huge thing in people's lives.
Do you guys want to go for a run?
Yeah!
It's such a beautiful day out for a run.
Star Wars was created by George Lucas and was an American epic space opera media franchise. The original film was made in 1977 and it became a worldwide pop culture phenomenon. Some of the TV stars who ruled the 70s go by the name of Alan Alda, Mary Tyler Moore, Farrah Fawcett, Jimmy Walker, Telly Savalas, Sonny and Cher, and Ricardo Montalban. The movie Jaws was an American thriller film directed by Steven Spielberg. It was released on June 20th in 1975.
You're gonna need a bigger boat. That's a 20-footer.
25. 3 tons of them.
Hurry up, he's coming straight for us. Don't screw it up now. Don't wait for me. Now! Shoot!
Happy Days was a popular sitcom television series in 1974, created by Gary Marshall. It became one of the biggest successes in television history and heavily influenced the television style of its time.
Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday. Sky, hello blue. There's nothing can hold me when I hold you. It feels so right, it can't be wrong. Rocking and rolling all week long.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy?
Welcome to the 70s Fashion Show. Fashion of the 70s was very diverse, reflecting a new interest in self-expression. No look compressed the decade, which was a mixed look of hippie, bohemian, retro, and punk. The general look was long hair with shaggy cuts, high-waisted pants, platform shoes for both sexes, bright colors, bold prints, and geometric shapes. After all the crisis of the mid-70s, this educated the youth program to wear clothing that expressed their individuality. Jogging suits not only became popular for working out, but also as everyday outfits. They became popular in 1975. The first tracksuit that was created was Adidas and was created by a German soccer player. Crop tops and tube tops were highly popularized by the hippie movement. Men and women both wore these because they thought it gave them a natural look. Bell bottoms are a style of pant that widen at the knee, down to the ankle, and make a bell shape down your leg. Sonny and Cher made these popular by wearing them on TV. They can be made out of many different materials such as denim, cotton, and polyester. Daisy Dukes are a form of short shorts usually worn by women. They became most popular by the movie Dukes of Hazzard. Platform shoes are known as the party shoe. They are worn in dramatic and showy ways. Disco goers use these to bring attention to themselves on the dance floor. Moon boots were created in the early 70s as a style of a snow boot. They became most popular after the movie Apollo 11. They were also worn to protect you at the ankle to keep a sturdy balance.
Some of the fads in the 1970s were puka shell necklaces, a pet rock, moon rings, Star Wars action figures, a dashboard hula girl, and 8-track tape player. More fads of the 1870s were roller skates, afros, space hoppers, a wall telephone, Simon the game, a stretch Armstrong, and water beds. Those are some of the fads in the 1970s.
Easy go, little high. We are family. I've got all my sisters with me. We are family. Everybody get up and sing.
Thank you.
got one place to go. Times in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Lean on me when you're not strong.
Be your friend. I'll help you carry on.
Hold it all away.
Mama!
Films of the 1970s include Love Story, Fiddler of the Roof, The Godfather, The Exorcist, The Towering Inferno, Jaws, Rocky, Star Wars, Grease, and Kramer vs. Kramer. Grease was a 1978 American musical romantic comedy. It was released on June 16th in 1978. It became one of the highest-grossing musical films ever at the time, and it was based on the 1971 Broadway musical of the same name.
Ready?
Family Feud is an American television game show created by Mark Goodson, where two families compete to name the most popular responses to survey questions in order to win cash and prizes. It first aired on July 12th in 1976.
It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Mitchell family. Jerry, Dorothy, Connie, Christy, and Carol. Ready for action. And the Perkins family. Maudy, Stretch, Barbara, Ken, and Royetta. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
The movie Rocky was written by the star Sylvester Stallone and was released on November 21st in 1976. The inspiration for Rocky was a real-life fight between the world heavyweight champion Muhammad Ali and a little-known club fighter named Chuck Wepner. Concludes the news of the 70s. See you next decade.